guilty of all three charges, sentence you to 20 years in state prison.
And seeing the turmoil going on in this courtroom and the woebegone face of the young lady in front of the judge, staring at him in disbelief, the dramatic yells and wails of her mother falling to the floor in pain and shock because her baby is going to prison. Now, normally when we look at this, it looks like a gross miscarriage of justice. A young girl being sent away to prison to waste her young, youthful years in a cold, hard judicial system that doesn't care. That would be the normal narrative. And on the surface, you see it every day. But wait until you see and hear the rest of the story. Daytona Beach. An 18-year-old woman was sentenced Tuesday to 20 years in state prison for using a dating app to set up a robbery that resulted in the shooting of another teen. As Circuit Court Judge Matthew Foxman read the sentence, Ky'Andrea Cook's mother dropped to the floor of the courtroom and wailed. Howls of grief from Cook's mother were so loud that the judge had to later restate the sentencing for the clerk. 20 years on a carjacking charge, 15 years attempted carjacking with a deadly weapon, and 15 years for battery felony. The sentences are concurrent. As part of her plea agreement, a conspiracy charge was dropped. That charge carried a maximum penalty of life in prison. The plea deal didn't challenge prosecutors' assertion in March when she was a mainland high school student. Cook lured Perry Nita, a 27-year-old Palm Coast man, to a meeting in South Daytona where he expected to sell her some marijuana and then they would have sex. Nita brought 17-year-old Emmanuel Purcell from Palm Coast, who ended up shot by Cook's boyfriend who was waiting to rob them, investigators said. Cook was arrested April 27th in connection to two violent carjackings and the March shooting of the teen. Detectives believe Cook and several accomplices used the Meet Me phone app to lure victims to an area where they would be carjacked, South Daytona Beach Lieutenant Dan Dietrich said at the time. When Nita and Purcell went to meet Cook the night of March 22nd in South Daytona, Nita became suspicious and hid the marijuana in a bush before picking Cook up, the report states. When she got into the truck, Cook told Nita she had to get some money, and when she returned, a man with a mask got into the back seat. At first, the man pointed a gun with a laser sight at Nita and told him to get out of the pickup, police said. But Purcell pushed him out of the truck. Then the unidentified man then fired off two rounds. One of them struck Purcell in the stomach. Tuesday morning, Judge Foxman acknowledged that Cook, who wrote the letter to the judge that she is an honor student, did not pull the trigger during the incident and that the victim luckily survived. This was intentional. It was an orchestrated ambush, and you are a main part of that, Foxman said. For that I am going to adjudicate you guilty for all three charges and sentence you to 20 years in state prison. With that, Cook's mother let out a howling wail and sank to the floor of the courtroom, 6, at the St. James Foxman's Justice Center. While Cook had retained composure throughout the proceeding, she lost it then. Tears streamed from Cook's eyes as she called out to her mother, Lashawanda Ponder. She fell to the ground and sheriff's deputies tried to help her up as other courtroom personnel attended to her mother. Purcell's mother sat stoically as the emotional scene unfolded. Earlier in the sentencing hearing, Vicki Ahrens told the judge that a bullet remains embedded in her son's pelvis and he will never be the same. She opened up the door and said she was very sorry. Ahrens said, relaying information from her son. Ahrens said the first bullet went through her son's hat and into the frame of the truck. The second bullet went through my son, Ahrens said. The bullet went through his stomach, through his liver, through his intestines, and now rests in his pelvic area. It missed his heart by 1/2 inch. Doctors have told her it would be more dangerous to remove the bullet. Prosecutors said, though Cook has given them the name of the possible shooter, no other suspects have been charged. Ahrens said Cook could have cooperated more quickly. Now I'm going to play you sound from the court proceedings.
18-year-old Ky'Andrea Cook's sentencing hearing Tuesday. Cook was charged with carjacking, attempted carjacking, and felony battery in a case that resulted in the shooting of another teen, Emmanuel Purcell of Palm Coast. The next voice you'll hear is Vicki Ahrens, Purcell's mother, speaking to Judge Matthew Foxman.
My son's name is Emmanuel Purcell. He's 17 years old. He works at Steak and Shake, and a co-worker offered to give him a ride to work that night. I did not know that he was coming to Daytona. The co-worker was to meet this girl. And that's when they proceeded. She opened up the door and said that she was sorry. And another guy jumped into the behind the driver's side and pulled a gun on my son's coworker. My son pushed the guy out of the truck. When he pushed the guy out of the truck, he pulled his hands together. He fired 2 shots. The first bullet went through my son's hat into the rim, to the frame of the truck. The second bullet went through my son. My son now has trouble doing everyday things, putting on socks and shoes. My son was set to go into the military in July. His life has been changed. He's not the same. He can't work full-time anytime. He graduated early with honors.
Next, you'll hear Judge Foxman ask Assistant State Attorney John Reed about the status of the shooter.
What's the status, criminal justice-wise, of the actual shooter?
It's still being investigated. The problem we have with this case is Ms. Cook was the one who drew him there. She had a social media, this meet me app to bring him there. That she, when she brought him there, there's 4 masked men did the robbery.
No, with her, with Manny's case, there was only 1 man and her.
Right.
And then, her and boyfriend and her.
And that's correct. In the other case, there's 4. So was there the other 3 there for the first week that we were for the other? The problem is they're all masked, so we don't have an ID. The police are still investigating. We know who he is. She's told us the name. I mean, I know who it is, but can you prove that beyond a reasonable doubt is the issue, and that's still, is he ever going to fully recover?
No. Bending will always be in, bending at his normal activities, skateboarding, motocross, all that's gone. And he has a hard time skateboarding. And that was his life.
In this next sequence, Lashonda Latrell Ponder, Cook's mother, explains how she believes her daughter fell into the wrong crowd.
after she got raped. And once she got down here, it's like she got out the wrong crowd. She always kept it great. She worked. The little boy was a problem since day one, since I saw him. I knew he was troubled. When I saw it, when I heard about what happened, you know, it broke my heart because she wasn't raised that way. And my heart goes out to the victim, mother too, because I am a mother. This just wasn't her. It was like shocking. I just feel like she was falling behind somebody else.
Judge Foxman gives Cook the last word and an opportunity to explain what happened.
All right, come on up, Ms. Cook. You get to say the final words.
I just want to say that I'm sorry to the mom that her son had to get shot, because I didn't even know he was going to get shot. My boyfriend and his friends did threaten me to do this. I didn't even know what was going on until I was at the wrong place at the wrong time. I didn't even know I was going to get shot. I wasn't scared of getting shot. I just want to say that I asked for forgiveness when she said I get a chance so I can get out and finish school and I can put my mama proud, because I want to be her first child to bring home a high school diploma. And I just want to make my mama proud. That's it.
You talked about wanting to go to the Army as well, correct?
Yes, sir.
You still want to do that?
Yes, sir.
All right, Ms. Cook, you're before the court for sentencing. A couple of things going in your favor. One, you didn't hold a firearm during these episodes. The second is that the victim luckily survived. That being said, this was intentional. It was an orchestrated ambush, and you are a main part of that. And for that, I'm going to go ahead and adjudicate you guilty of all three charges, sentence you to 20 years in state prison.
Now, you heard the excuses that her mom gave, and I read you the letter that Ms. Cook wrote to the judge that said she really didn't deserve the sentence, or that heavy of a sentence, because she didn't fire the gun and the man did live. No harm, no foul. I'm 18 years old. I want to go back to school and resume my normal life. I'm sorry for the victim that he's gut shot and has a bullet resting in his gut and he'll never be the same. But I'm a woman, I'm a girl, I make mistakes. I was misled by a man, or as her mother calls it, a boy, that was trouble. And possibly I should have known better, I should have listened to my mother, but it's still not my fault. I am not responsible for myself. Even though she used her wiles, her feminine wiles, to attract three different men in carjackings, and this one could have been fatal. I'm sorry somebody got hurt, but I really don't deserve to go to prison, which is what she's really saying, which is what her mother's saying. She was a honor student and she was doing good until she got raped. And then she went off the rails. It was a man's fault that raped her and caused her to go bad. It was a man's fault that caused her to run with the wrong crowd. It was a man's fault that tricked her three times into carjacking people through an app. No black man or black father would have ever said that. They were told that boy he has to be held accountable for what he did. Just because she wasn't raised like that, or she, her mother says she wasn't raised like that. Obviously, if you notice the two different last names, she's a single mother. So was the boy that got shot that was hanging out with a weed seller right along. Had the roles been reversed, that boy, even though he didn't pull a trigger, would have got the same sentence, which is a total of maximum life imprisonment that all his other buddies get, because it happens all the time. If somebody dies or somebody does something like this within conspiracy, everybody gets the same sentence. Because she's a woman, she used her skirts. Her skirts worked partially, but it wasn't good enough. The judge wasn't buying it. Not today. You're black and you don't get a white woman's privilege. I don't think a white woman would get that kind of privilege. You're part of an armed robbery group that carjacks people, takes their stuff at gunpoint, and you knew the deal. And now, after you get caught and you're facing the judge, I want to be a little girl again. Sad commentary on how we raise women nowadays. There's always been bad boys and boys that do bad stuff. But boys that do bad stuff like that also know there's a downside and there's a risk. And when it comes time to pay, they pay up. They go to prison and they take accountability for themselves. I wonder when black women are going to raise their daughters to do the same. That's all I'm saying. That's all I got for this very, very sad story, because I do feel for this girl. The shock on her face and the realization that her young life, her youth is over, is going to be spent behind bars. As a father, it breaks my heart. But as a man, I know that when you do something like that, you have to take accountability for your actions and be held accountable for your actions. Don't do the crime if you can't do the time. With that, that's all I got. This is BGS out.